and welcome. Today we will see one mathematical process which is called as the correlation. The correlation, it gives the similarity between the two signals. It is having lots of applications such as image processing in radar systems where we have to compare the two data sequences. Suppose we are having one spacecraft available in the space, and one signal, it is transmitted from a radar system. Let us denote it by the x of n. Now the reflected signal from that spacecraft, let us denote it as a y of n. So radar system, it compares these two data sequences. That is, it compares the x of n and y of n. And it finds out the actual distance of this object over here. So to compare these two data sequences, here we use the correlation property. Similarly, if we consider the example of image processing, when we want to compare the two images and find out the similarity between that two images, the correlation can be used over here. So it is having the large applications in the signal processing. So let us see how correlation can be represented mathematically. So here we are having the term Rxy of L, which is defined by this mathematical equation, that is summation from n is equal to minus infinity up to infinity of x of n into y of n minus L. So it is nothing but the comparison between the x of n and y of n. But here we are just shifting the sample L with different values. So this equation, it gives the cross correlation between the x and y. Similarly, we can have another one equation for the cross correlation, that is R of xy of L is equal to summation from n is equal to minus infinity up to infinity x of n plus n into y of n. Let us see one simple example for the comparison of the two data sequences. Here we are having x of n, which is having these different samples, and another sequence y of n, which is having again these samples over here, and we have to form the cross correlation between these two sequences. We are having the standard equation of the cross correlation. So let us solve it step by step. So in the first step, let us represent once again the signals, that is the x of n and y of n. So here this arrow indicates the zero point or the zeroth sample. So let us substitute L is equal to 0 in the standard equation of the cross correlation. So here we will find the cross correlation between the x and y for the zeroth sample. When we substitute the value of L is equal to 0 in the standard equation, so equation will be nothing but the multiplication of the two sequences and the summation from n is equal to minus infinity up to plus infinity. So let us do this multiplication and addition process. So we are multiplying here the different samples of x of n and y of n. So after doing this mathematical operation, we will get this result. Let us go for the substitution of the next value of L. So here one important point to be noted, that when L's value it is greater than 0, at that time the signal y of n is to be shifted on the right side by the L units. So here we are substituting the value of L is equal to 1. So equation, it is reducing like this way. And here the y of n signal, it is shifted towards the right side by the 1 sample. So again, following the same procedure of the multiplication and addition, we are getting the second point R of xy over here. Similarly, let us apply L is equal to 2. Again, we have to note that the signal y of n, it will be shifted to the right side by the 2 samples. And same procedure of multiplication and addition is to be followed. And after that, we are getting one more value of R of xy. In fourth step, let us apply L is equal to 3. Same procedure again we have to follow, that is the y of n will be shifted to the right side by the L sample, and same we are multiplying the two samples of this x of n and y of n, and finally we are getting this value. In next step, we are applying the value of L is equal to 4. So equation of the standard cross correlation will reduce like this way. As usual, the signal y of n, it will shift to the right side by the 4 samples. And again, individual multiplication of these two samples, it will give the cross correlation between the r of x, y. Let us follow the same procedure for the L is equal to 5, and we are getting the different values of r of x, y. Similarly, we have to apply the L's value which are less than 0. In such a case, the signal y of n, it will shift to the left side by the L units. So here, in same way, we can apply the different values of L, that is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5 or minus 6. And after that, we are getting r of x, y in this fashion. So after that, this r x, y, it gives the resemblance, or we can say that it gives the cross correlation between the signal x and y over here.